Okay, this patient, she is a patient admitted more than 2 months ago in the intensive care unit because a septic shock due to liver abscess and a secondary acute respiratory distress syndrome. Now the patient has she's become better from septic shock. She remains with a respiratory failure. She is now on assist ventilation and pressure support. And we can see the parameters of pressure support ventilation, as now the patient is on 5 centimeters waters of PEEP, a low FiO2, and the pressure support that is more 14 centimeters water above PEEP. And if you look at the parameters like respiratory rate and tidal volume, you can see that the patient she's receiving an adequate amount of ventilation because the respiratory rate is below 20 and the tidal volume is 6.5 milliliters per kilo of predicted body weight. So I can say that the patient looks adequately ventilated with these parameters of assisted ventilation. Even the blood gas analysis is okay with this ventilatory setting. But the true problem is that what we can say about diaphragm activity on this ventilatory setting without EDI. I can talk about adequacy of ventilation because of respiratory rate and tidal volume, and because I can't see any ineffective efforts or any major asynchrony on the flow curve. But I think I need something more. And something more is EDI signal. So let's see what's happened when we display an EDI signal on the ventilator through an EDI catheter. As you can see, we don't have any EDI activity displayed on the ventilator. But we have some degree of flow asynchrony. The flow asynchrony means lack of proportionality between patient needings and ventilator assistance. You don't have almost nothing performed by the diaphragm, but you have a plenty activity of ventilator. So let's try to decrease the pressure support and see if we can see something more coming from the diaphragm. We'll go down in 3 centimeter water steps and we will look at the EDI signal. As you can see, there is an effective effort. Something more happens. I can see something coming from the diaphragm. It's still very low in amplitude. So I think I can go down further, 3 centimeters water step. Let's wait a few seconds. It's very important not to resize the EDI scale because you can't appreciate the variation. Mm-hmm. As you can see, the diaphragm is starting to work. Mm-hmm. We don't have any ineffective force on the flow curve, but even on the diaphragm EDI curve. The diaphragm activity is still low, so maybe I can go down a little bit with pressure super. Remember, we're starting from 15. We have lost 7 centimeter waters of pressure super above people. Let's go down to 5, and let's see what's happened. we can see that the EDI peak is increasing. We lack some tidal volume, but we don't have high respiratory rate now. We have to wait that the patient, the central respiratory drive of the patient can understand that they missed some support from ventilation and generate a more intense signal for the diaphragm. Let's see if it will happen in the next few minutes. Okay, at the moment we have a good diaphragmatic activity. We have a still low tidal volume that maybe is not enough, but we will see on the blood gas analysis. We don't have high respiratory rate. If the patient will not increase the EDI peak too much, I guess this set is a good set of ventilation for this patient. We will check the blood gas analysis in a few minutes. We will check the EDI activity in a few minutes. But if the EDI peak is stable, I can say that the patient is properly working with the diaphragm and the patient had lost almost 10 centimeter waters of pressure support. That means that the patient was really over-assisted before, even if respiratory rate and tidal volume tell us that the level of assistance was adequate.